Today on New Things, New Tech, I am unboxing and setting up this brand new Huion Kamvas GT-220 version 2 drawing tablet that I plan to be using with Blender, especially the version 2.8 grease pencil, Photoshop, and other digital drawing programs. Today I just received this giant box from Amazon for my Huion GT-220 version 2 drawing tablet. Now we're going to open this thing up and see what we've got inside here. Oh, look at this. Inside our Amazon box, we've got another box. So it's a two-box unboxing. Let's take this one out. This guy here. Alrighty. This is our Huion shipping box. So we'll take a look inside this guy and see what we've got. Find the cut. But wait, there's more. We get a third box inside the box. Here we've got, what else have we got? So this is cool. They put wood on both sides of the inner box to actually help protect this thing during shipping. That's really kind of nice. I'm excited to get this thing open and find out what we've got going on in here. Hey, look at this. We've got a nice little thank you for choosing Huion. Thank you for choosing Huion. Our goal is for you to be 100% happy with your new Huion project. If you need any assistance, please don't hesitate to call. I'll tell you what, their packaging is really cool right here. Get a nice little thank you card. So on top, looks like we've got a little box here. Ooh, a little box of goodies. What's inside our little box of goodies? On top, it says we have a gift. What is our gift? Let's take a look at this. Looks like a nice little drawing glove. So yeah, we get a nice little two-finger glove here. Gotta be smarter than the glove. Wait a minute. I can do it. Nope, sorry. Gotta be smarter than the glove here. Here we go. Oh, there we go. All right, so now we got our little drawing glove that we can actually sit there and draw and be all spiffy. I guess to keep down our smudges and so forth, so that should be really nice. It'd be Michael Jackson. Oh look, a nice little cleaning cloth. Standard USB 2 cable. Here is another USB cable with a power adapter. It's for charging something here. Ooh, they give you a screwdriver. So that tells me we're gonna put something together. Looks like a power cable. Here is our power brick. Oh yeah, we have some screws up here, so I'm assuming that's what our screwdriver's for, is to use on those screws. And, ooh, look, a little hand thingy. Wow. Ooh, what do we got inside here? Looks like we have some nibs on the inside there. Total of 8 additional nibs right there. All right. So we have this guy here. Lay this down carefully. And inside we have some more goodies. We get what appears to be a pen. And yeah, here's our pen right here. So, nice little pen there. Oh, got a place here to plug in. I bet you that's for the power supply. So that would be, woohoo! So now we can charge our pens up real quick. And we got another one over here. Looks, says a gift. This looks to be another pen. Now I can draw with both hands. You gotta be ambidextrous to do that. A regular VGA cable. This is an HDMI cable. This looks to be the stand support. Now we know what we need our screws for to be able to mount this on. We have our warranty card. Our graphics pen display manual. Our CD. Cool. And our monitor. Congratulations, you have got the free upgrades. It says, you have got the free upgrades. Ooh, we've upgraded the pin sensitivity from 2048 levels to 8192 levels. Sweet. Our giant static free bag here. Take our tablet out of there. All right. Yeah, we got a screen protector over a nice glossy glass, which actually gives you a nice textured looking surface here to draw on. So on the back side, we have our USB, power, VGA, DVI, HDMI. And our bumper there, button controls. So set that guy down there. Go ahead and put this on. Take our screws. Our screwdriver. Probably should check the book, make sure we get this in the right way. It actually shows right here. So we're seeing our setup here, right like that. So that's all the way down, it looks like. We can adjust it to different heights. All right, well, let's look at this thing hooked up and see what it looks like. Okay, so we're ready to install this Huion monitor. For my setup, I already have three monitors. Originally, I thought I'd replace my center monitor with a new Huion and make it my main display. But now, I'm thinking I'll just add it as a fourth monitor and set it down in front. Also, I have a standing desk, and I'll have to route the cables to be able to work with the desk with an elevated or sitting height. The included HDMI cable isn't long enough, so I'm using one that's a tad longer. The monitor needs a USB plug to give feedback from the pen touchscreen. The power cord and brick is plenty long enough, so there's no problem there. Since I use a Mac keyboard on my PC, I can just plug into one side of the keyboard. Alrighty, we're all plugged in and ready to go. The monitor came with a CD for drivers, but downloading the latest version from Huion's website is a good idea. Most systems now don't come with a CD drive anyway. So the drive install was really simple. Open up the Huion tablet program. So under the style pen, looks like we can set up the buttons and pressure sensitivity. Well, that works pretty good. Windows Sync is also supported, meaning that the pen can interact better with Microsoft applications. Under the button selections, looks like you can configure the buttons to do just about any Windows command, run a program, type test, etc. By default, the top button is the mouse right button, and the bottom button is the switch brush button. We'll leave those alone for now. And also some form of game acceleration selection. Under the work area, looks like we can define which monitor to use and how much to use. Not sure what the difference is here on these two buttons. So for the custom area, it looks like you can define how much of the screen to use. One appears to be full screen, 0.5 appears to be half. So first, I think I'll choose the monitor to use. So from this dropdown, we can cycle to the monitor that is correct for the Huion tablet. You can try the identity selection in the Windows display settings, but I found that typically shows monitor numbers that do not match up to application display numbers. So by selecting it from the dropdown, I can see that the screen is there. Next, clicking on the monitor calibration, and a crosshair appears with a red dot up in the upper left here, and is displayed with tiny instructions that tell us to click on the red dot of the cross center. Click that, here, and here. This row, next, here, 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 here again, and done. So at this point, the monitor should be set up with the best parallax to the pen when the monitor is at this angle. By looking at the pen location as relation to the cursor on the screen, we can see that there is a bit of a gap depending upon the angle we view it at. This will determine how accurate the tip to the cursor is, thus parallax. Well, simply put anyway. So it's a good idea to calibrate the monitor for the angle that you will do most of your drawings. All right, now it's time to test the drawing in a few programs. Probably the best place to start is Photoshop. So in Photoshop, I tested a basic brush with pressure sensitivity and wrote out hello. So the pressure and real-time drawing appears really good. Nice and smooth. So next, I'm gonna draw out a character pose of King Hubert from Sleeping Beauty. Why? Well, I figured I'd start with something I had a quick reference to, and well, Disney 2D animation is king. I didn't change the brush, I just varied the pressure of the pen. No, it's very quick and responsive and appears to draw where I want it to. Even when drawing small areas around the eyes, without zooming in, I was able to get the detail I was after. Lastly, I used an eraser brush to do some SketchUp cleanup. Hindsight, I probably should have put my first pencil sketch in a different layer. Oh well. So my final ink sketch looks pretty good. Now, I switched over to Blender and am using the Alpha 2 version, which is dated 11.7. Selecting the 2D drawing workspace, I tested out the brushes just to get a feel for how well it works with this pen. Not quite as responsive as Photoshop, but then this is still an alpha version and I'm still learning how to use it. But still quite impressive on the pressure sensitivity. So I decided to draw the same pose in Blender that I did in Photoshop to compare. First, I did a rough blue line on a separate layer, and then I moved to a line layer to sketch in the pencil mode. Overall, not too bad. Blender Grease Pencil draws in a series of connected vertex points, so it's possible to go into the sculpt mode and smooth out all the lines, add remove thicknesses, and etc. But for now, the basic pencil sketch looks pretty fair for a first-time sketch. So the Huion Kamvas GT-220 version 2 graphics pen tablet is very nice. I spent a little time working with it and intend on using that for much of my drawing 2D and 3D work to come. You can expect to see more videos, tutorials, and animation shows in the near future working with the Huion drawing tablet. The monitor is easy to unpack, set up, and use. The packaging is top-notch, and you can rest assured that your monitor will arrive with no damage under most shipping conditions. Huion does a great job packing in lots of extras to support this drawing monitor, with two pens at the ready, extra nibs, a drawing glove, cable, and easy-to-set-up software. The instructions may have a little English translation and spelling issues, but it doesn't detract from the good quality of this drawing tablet monitor. The screen can be used with the included screen protector, which gives the image a slightly duller matte finish, or without, on the glossy screen. But if you use the monitor without the screen protector, then the glove will probably be a must use to reduce friction and keep the smudges down while drawing. Either way, you're going to have to clean off residue from the monitor or screen protector every so often. The responsiveness of the pen is excellent, with little or no delay, and the pressure sensitivities is as good as a drawing program will allow you that you're using. I haven't had a chance to test Huion support, as I found all the information I need on the website and documentation. Is this drawing tablet as good as a Wacom's Antique? Probably not. But for the price point of $485 versus the Cintiq 22 HD, which has a 21-inch pin display and costs $1,700, this Huion is a great choice for the beginner, artist working in a digital drawing realm, or even a seasoned professional. For on the go, my iPad Pro can easily beat this Huion in drawing smoothness, sensitivity, and use. But it's still a more expensive choice that doesn't have options or abilities that a desktop drawing program has. So I intend to use the Huion in daily work to create 2D and 3D drawings and animation, primarily with Blender 2.80 and beyond, as well as Photoshop and other drawing programs. Well, that's it for this segment on the Huion GT-220 version 2 drawing tablet monitor. I'm Scott Drudge for New Things, New Tech. Thanks for watching. Check out some of our other great videos and more on the way. Subscribe and leave comments below.